Disclaimer, I am not a computer expert and this is not a tech channel. I'm just sharing my personal experience using this Lenovo laptop as an engineering student, and I did some light video editing on it. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So this is a laptop review video. And by the way, I'm studying chemical engineering, which we use some software like AutoCAD, MATLAB, and Microsoft Excel a lot. So this is Lenovo Ideapad Gaming 3. I bought this 2 months ago. Before I buy this laptop, I knew nothing about what is CPU, GPU, etc. So I'm not going to talk a lot about the spec. I'm just trying to share my personal experience and what's the problem I face using this Lenovo laptop. Yeah. If you are considering buying a Lenovo Ideapad or Lenovo gaming laptop, so I hope you get to decide after you watch this video. The first thing I'm going to talk about is battery. So I found a lot of review online. They say the battery is pretty good, which like stay for a very long time, but for my personal experience, I think it's drained quite fast if you didn't turn on the battery saving mode. And one thing I find about the battery saving mode is when I switch on, the screen become very dull and I don't really like it. So usually I didn't switch on the battery saving mode, and it drains quite fast. So I'm going to talk about its downside first. Why you shouldn't considering buying this laptop? The first thing is it has only 2 USB ports. It's quite inconvenient because I use wireless mouse. So you can see one of them is already occupied by the wireless mouse, leave me only one USB port. And it's quite inconvenient when sometimes I want to plug in hard disk and drive at the same time. One of the problems with this laptop is heating issues. So I found a couple of reviews online before I buy this laptop is saying the heating is an issue for like most of the Lenovo laptops. I found that every time I run Adobe Premiere Pro for like a few hours, then it starts heating, and when it starts heating, it turns on the fan. So the fan is so loud. I'm going to show you a footage I took yesterday when I was exporting my videos after like a few hours of editing. So you can see it's so loud. However, actually, the heating issues can be solved by buying a cooling pad. I highly recommend you to buy one with adjustable height, which makes your typing experience more comfortable and good for your back and neck too. Another problem I have using this laptop is when I run Adobe Premiere Pro, it crashes sometimes. Not so often, but still acceptable because I only have 8GB of RAM. Because I know that suggested RAM for Adobe Premiere Pro is like 16GB of RAM, so yeah, it's acceptable that it crashes sometimes. Yeah, and the last downside I found is it has only one color, so you can't choose the color, it's only dark blue. And dark blue I think is not a go-to color for most of the girls, but for me personally, I like dark blue, so yeah, it's not a problem for me. Yeah, and I do prefer if they have like more choices of colors, because I think this dark blue is a bit boring. And my mom don't like dark blues. She likes like rose gold, pink color, like bright color. So she was prohibiting me from buying this laptop because of its color. Yeah, so I think this is one of the downsides where you can't choose the color. Well, after talking about its downside, so it's time for me to talk about why you should buy this laptop. So first, I think it can run most of the software that I need like smoothly. Yeah, the software I've been using is like AutoCAD, MATLAB, Microsoft Excel a lot, Word of course, PowerPoint, and what else? Adobe Premiere Pro, Photoshop, and I think it runs like quite smooth most of the time. Another good thing about this is because I was using only 4GB RAM for my last laptop, and when I draw AutoCAD, I can't watch tutorial at the same time, and it has 8GB. While I'm drawing AutoCAD, I can watch tutorial video on YouTube at the same time, which is pretty awesome, I think. And I can search for some like background music or some image that I need while I'm editing video doing Photoshop. It allows me to open like one heavy software and another like just Google Chrome at the same time, which is like pretty good for students, I think, most of the time, because when we are using some software, we just want to search, like we are stuck, we just want to search for some tutorial. So yeah, and it's pretty good. It can run most of the software that I need smoothly. Yeah, and that's the thing, right? I just want it to like run it smoothly, don't be freezing all the time. And the next thing I like about it is screen, and you can see that it's 15.6 inches screens, and the screen percentage is quite good, because you can see this, yeah, very big, right? Screen is very good, like in when you want to watch movie, watch YouTube. Another thing I like about it is it has a privacy camera shutter, so you can just like close your camera. So when you see a red dot over here, it just means that your camera is already like there's a shutter, so they won't see you doing like whatever. Because you know, at this time we use like online meeting platform a lot, and yeah, we need to like switch on and off our camera, so it's quite good that have like another protection, so that you won't like accidentally switch on the cam. And this laptop has a GTX 1650 graphic card. I think it's like more than enough for a non-gaming person, where I run AutoCAD sometimes and video editing like Photoshop. So for this price, this graphic card I think is not bad. Yeah, if you are just doing paperwork, I think this is quite heavy for you, but I think if you need some extra like processor for the software like AutoCAD, or you want to do some video editing, graphic design, something like this, I think this weight is quite acceptable. I searched online, it's 2.2 kg. At first I was going to buy this, and I saw it's 2.2 kg online, and I feel like it's very just too heavy for me. But when I go to the store and I just hold it on my hand, and I think it's not that heavy for a gaming laptop. And I haven't go back to the campus yet, I'm doing online classes all the way, so probably when I need to carry it like around the campus, I will feel like it's heavy. But for a gaming laptop, it's okay, right? 2.2 kg. But when I hold it, I just feel like it's I feel like it's just like 1.7 something, so yeah, it's acceptable, right? I want to share another thing, which is the Lenovo backpack comes with the laptop. I love it so much. The volume is sufficient for uni students. There are small pockets to keep those tiny stuff. There is an individual compartment for your laptop with good protection. And its design just makes it so comfortable to my bag to carry it around. And the main compartment is quite big, and there are some small compartments inside for you to keep your stuff like pens, earbuds, and small notebooks. That's all for this video. So for this laptop, Ideapad Gaming 3, I'm quite satisfied with its performance. I think it's quite good for the price. I bought it at 3050 ringgit, so I think yeah, nothing to complain. Like there are some downside like the USB port and heating issues, but it's not a deal breaker for me, and I'm very satisfied with its performance, honestly. So I hope this video get to help you to decide like, are you going to buy this laptop? So yeah, thank you for watching. Bye.